Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my shop. Today we have a little repair project. A friend of mine complained about a rattling noise from her lawnmower. It turned out that one of the bearings had completely disintegrated and the other one was frozen. And the material of the plastic bearing seat was molten away from the friction of the outer ring rubbing against it. This is a rough sketch of the original design. Plan of attack was using a slightly bigger bearing and to clean up the damaged bearing seat. This is the seat of a small bearing. I made a plug matching this seat. The drilled hole was used to center the work. The work was clamped to the table on my milling machine. It was roughly centered by eyeball. And the probe tip of the centricator is inserted into the centering hole of the plug. The initial runout wasn't too bad. A few small adjustments of the X and Y axis brought the runout close to zero. Time for some Wohlhaupter action. I started with cleaning up the top surface of the housing around the bearing seat. The facing and boring head was set up for facing, so that the cutter advanced radially by a few tenths of a millimeter with each rotation. Thank you. After the first pass, the tool is moved back to the inner position. This process was repeated several times, with the table slightly raised each time. So this is the final pass. Cleaned up the face quite nicely. Now let's start boring out the actual bearing seat. The head was set to a fixed diameter. And the tool advanced with the auto feed of the quill. I took very light cuts. Unfortunately, the cutting action is taking place in front of the bore, where you can't see it. I'm sorry for that. The depth of the bore was limited by a quill stop. No, it doesn't go in. The tool was retracted and the table slightly raised. The cut was repeated. The slightly deeper boring operation finally cleaned up the bottom of the seat and removed all the molten material. So this is the final pass. It still didn't clean up the entire circumference. Anyways, the fit of the bearing was fine. Here I'm checking the distance between the two bearings. The spindle required some work. I started with center drilling. The inner race of the small bearing was stuck, so I just turned it down. The material was quite hard, as expected, but the bearing finally surrendered. I took care of the slightly wider new bearing and removed about 2 mm from the original shoulder. Now I'm pressing the spindle into the larger bearing. Note my very professional, not so hydraulic press. The small bearing was also pressed onto the spindle. Well, time for a test run. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. See you next time.